What up, guys? It's Guten Tag here today. I have finally gotten some time to do a review in my toolbox tour. It's been 3 years since I've done a toolbox tour. So we have now acquired a 54-inch master with a 54-inch master cabinet, a stainless steel top, and a classic hutch to go with that. A scrap box for miscellaneous parts and a Mag tool cart. I used to have a little black cart and used to only have this box here. So, as you can see here, guys, here's my hutch and toolbox review. This is what I've got. This is what I've built so far. And now we're going to come in here to the hutch. We're going to review the hutch at first. So, I got a snap-on light up top. It's powered by auto power, closing and opening. And then over here, I can turn this off. And then I got this this light system here. So we could go multi different colors here, guys. So we could do a strobe, we could do a quick flash between those two colors. We could do a slow oscillating color. I could do multi different colors. Let's do a green here. Got a purple, got a blue, got red. All right, let's go back into the white. So I get a soft white light here. All right, and then we're gonna turn that off here. One of the editor techs is getting paid, so he's got a job. So I got my coffee cup mug here. Let's see, I put a power strip in over here. This is my power area. I got my PM spec chart. Hey, my tire certification. Let's see here. Got me a nice little sound bar down here. A couple miscellaneous spots for my drills, extra safety glasses, spare pins. Well, let's see, my hat that I normally wear while working. I'm currently off work, so I had to do my review today. I got some hand soap over there, which I probably should use. I got some tape over here. Got some spare containers for bolts, parts, miscellaneous stuff like that. Got me this nice mat here. Sorting out parts, doing stuff. It's got, I just got this today from Snap-on. Got me my Snap-on light. I have to say this is a really good light. If anyone is looking for it, that's the part number there. I'll just talk to your Snap-on guy, and it's got a flashlight ahead of time, and it's a drop light. Let's see here. I also got my stream light here, which I'd put that back in its little holster, actually. Yeah, we'll put it in the holster. I charged it earlier today. So let's go into the top drawer here. And here's the top drawer of the toolbox today. So I got spare parts here. These are used for brass connections, dual jacking, connecting trucks to the airline, checking your glad hands, checking fittings and cutoff valves, checking your air system. I got a little spotlight. I got that from Harbor Freight. Got some drill bits here. Half inch impact, another half inch impact, electric half inch impact, a DeWalt drill here. Now, on this impact here, it's from Mac Tools, so I can take my DeWalt battery and put that in there. So yes, we got a DeWalt battery on a Mac Tool, and yes, it runs. Okay, having technical difficulties here, but okay. All right, we'll put that back. Put this back here. All right, got my ratchets here. My 3/4 half inch breaker bar, half inch snap-ins, old S&K. I got another, these ones here, are my other daily ratchets that I use all the time. My die grinder, my angle grinder with the purple disc wheel, my air hammer, a coolant testing kit. All right, so this will do for the first drawer here. Back to the hutch, man. Look at she's a beauty. I gotta say, if any of you mechanics out there ever have a problem with your guys's, they should get one of these toolboxes and your other coworker should read that. All right, we're gonna go to the second long drawer over here today. And on the second long drawer, I have spare sockets and miscellaneous sockets in various sizes. These are 12-point half-inch dry sockets. I have a dial indicator and a stand for the dial indicator. All my paperwork and everything here, some duct tape for the wheel eights, spare ratchets that I loan out to customers. And if they break them, they get to replace them, but hey, it happens. All right, we're gonna go to the first drawer over here on this side here. I got Allen wrenches, some cutting and scraping tools over here, hand chisels and punches over here. Some silicone for doing stuff, sealing up lights and stuff like that. We got the nut driver drawer here. I have a digital caliper, great tool, got it from Harbor Freight. The cheapy brake stuff every now and then. I got to do a brake line and personal vehicle, personal work, you know. Some extractor bits, and that's the nut driver drawer. This drawer here, I got the snap-on screwdrivers and the picks. These two picks here are in my boat because I have a bass casting rod that it gets burlapped all over. So I use those to undo my bird nest. So I get a bunch of utility blades and cutting stuff, air chucks and stuff like that. This bottom drawer over here today, I have some cleaners, brake cleaners, couple ratchet straps for holding up drive lines, my welding cutting torch mask, some knee pads. Those come in great and handy so you don't wear out your knees. We got to keep moving here. All right, so in this drawer here, I have my screwdrivers and pry bars. All right, and then we come over to the wrench drawer. I haven't had a chance to clean it up yet. It's a bit messy, but these are a majority of the spare wrenches. This is metric on this side. This is standard on this side. Got my Crescent wrenches and my big boy wrenches here. I love these. Yes, these are snap-on wrenches. I don't know where how much I paid for them. They were on a heck of a deal. I think for all of these, like $200, somewhere around there. Next drawer down I have here is the plier drawer. All right, so we got some snap ring pliers on this side. Those are by Snap-on. Let's see, I got two rivet guns for doing rivets on the back of the trailers. These are the Snap-on pipe wrench pliers. Great tool to have. They get out pipes and fittings and tubes that you wouldn't think you'd get on. They're great for holding on brake chamber clevises when you're trying to do that bolt. In this kit here, I have a Snap-on pliers. This plier is in my truck. I forgot to go grab that and put it back, but I'll make sure it gets put back because we don't want to lose our tools. So that would be the plier drawer. This drawer here, it's a little bit of a mess. This is the pipe wrenches, the C-clamps, my filter wrenches for the Davco, my hammer and punch for punching holes in oil filters, and then all my oil filter wrenches. I also have a Pittsburgh 3/4 inch drive set, somewhat big boy sockets. I haven't really needed anything more than a half inch out of that box. That comes in handy having all the time. All right, here in the bottom drawer today. Let's see here, I got me, in here is drill bits. As you can see there, I got me my grease gun, I got two electric drills, another strap in here, my actual grinder, my Sawzall, and then my hammer drawer as well, and then a couple air fittings, and this doohickey right here is one, oh, that's the wrong hose, This one, it takes me from the big hose to the little hose, which is a great tool to have as a diesel mechanic. All right. Next door I have over here today is stuck. Ha ha. Ah, there we go. These are torch bits and little more drill bits and my daily drill bits and daily bits and a tire bit here for reaming out tires. Next door is zip ties and cutoff wheels, O-rings, utility knife and little micro torch for melt and butt connectors and some cleaning discs. And oh hey, I was looking for this. That way I could change that grinder out later. I have that O-ring kit that comes in handy, repairing fittings. This drawer here is, got my hose cutter, a couple wire brushes, some files for cleaning some other stuff up. There's wheel seal tools here. It's a mess. I haven't fully got around to cleaning it all up, guys. I do apologize. I'm a busy man here. Busy. I got some other pry bars in here. And this drawer here, it looks like it's an electrical drawer, some headlamps, some extra flashlights, a powered cord drop lamp, my multimeter, and my test light with a voltage meter. I love this thing. Let's see here. This drawer is my glove drawer. Many different varieties of different gloves for different uses. Mostly doing PMs, I use those. Doing tires and wheel seals, it'd be these or these, sometimes these. Just depends on where I'm at and what I feel like grabbing that day. Next drawer here, it's just a miscellaneous drawer. It kind of just became a spare light drawer that drivers wanted to replace lights and they didn't want to keep them. They got some new lights. I still have my Boxer Streamlight because I needed to keep that for a warranty. This guy here, as you can see, is a truck wheel stud installer. It's a great tool to have. I have two of these. This is the second one. This is the spare one, actually. And what you do is you follow your instructions. If you need one, you can go to your Snap-on dealer and give them the 28950, and he could get you this part. I'm sure any of the other dealers might be able to get it too, but you basically put the wheel on there like so, and it helps you install a wheel stud on a semi truck. All right, we're getting to the last drawer here. Last drawer here is the hard hat, the bump hat. This is the tire bag tool. So quickly going on road call, I grab that and go. Other tools and other stuff go in that bag there. There's just some spare gas skid stuff and spare parts in there that are extra that customers didn't want. They told me I can keep them. All right, coming over here to the side, give you one more look at this bad boy. All right, we're all finished on that box. So right here, guys, I got a Mac Tool Creeper. It is very worn, very well used. It's got ran over 3 times. All right, and then coming over to the Mack cart here. And on the Mack cart here, I have... Oh, he's got a cattle trailer outside. I smell it. All right, so I got my extensions here for 1/2 inch and 3/8 drive. I got my Torx bits, some other ones, metric and standard, and then these are the star nut 1/2 inch drive. Just a moment, I got a truck pulling into the shop. All right, back to where we were, guys. I got another one of those PM charts over here. All right, and there's my Torx bits and miscellaneous. Coming over to the top of the orange box here is my daily sockets that I use. All right, so we have 2 ratchets here, a ratchet here. Those are all 1/2 inch. This is a 3/8 drive. There's a hand 1/4 inch nut driver to go with this set. And There's two extra adapters here, which are the longer ones. I have some big boy sockets here. This is for the square studs on some of the trailers, the inner and outers. My driveline socket, a wheel alignment socket, 3/4 for holding big stuff. A half inch, 3/4 to 1/2 inch, and then a 1 inch to 3/4, so I can use the other smaller stuff. This is a 1/4 inch drive. This is an old set. This is the first set that I had, and I made it, and I've lost some out of there. In that, my DeWalt bit kit here has got some miscellaneous nut kits for the DeWalt impacts. Back here, I have a brake chamber socket. This is a 3/4 deep well, allowing you to use a brake chamber bolt. So down here we have the scrap bin. All right, so we're gonna come over here. So your brake chamber socket comes on it like so, allowing you to put that in your brake chamber and taking that off. All right, guys, I'm gonna put that back over here. Down here on the side, I have a little magnetic tray. And then up here are my metric half-inch drive sockets. That is a 36 millimeter socket I use for my Detroit filters. My regular standard half-inch drive, 33 millimeter for the semi-trucks. Those come in handy. I use those in my half-inch impact, and it saves me time, so I don't have to go find a big impact. Then, this is my 3/8 drive, deep and shallow. We have the missing a few here. It happens. We're mechanics. We lose stuff. This is the metric deep and metric shallow sockets. This guy should be here. This here is an expert socket set, and that is my metric deep, metric shallow, metric standard deep, standard shallow. These here sockets are specialty sockets that I use. These four on this end are driveline sockets. These ones are some other drive stuff. So those are some of the specialty sockets. Coming over into the first drawer here today, I have some more pliers. This is mostly my electrical plier drawer, and you can see all that stuff. Spare parts and miscellaneous stuff, my torch and my two torch ends. This is a torch bit set here. That's missing some too, unfortunately. Those guys are all elsewhere. I do not absolutely need it. This is my daily go-to wrench drawer. I pretty much have everything wrenched in here that I need to work on 90% of what I'm doing on these trucks. My shorts, metric and standards, metric and standard, some box stand wrenches, a line wrench for the DPS, my bigger wrenches, and these are my... This is this section from about here to here is about my airbag or my brake chambers and basic hoses. You know, those come in handy there. All right, this is a scrap drawer of lights and wires and butt connectors and heat shrinks and miscellaneous random stuff here. All right, and then down underneath, I got me a couple buckets, and they just got some spare junk in it. This here, like I said, is just a spare nuts and bolts box. We don't want to bore you with that. All right, guys, well, I'd like to say this is where we have built out to in the last few years. I have a big pipe right down there for getting stuff broken loose. All right, guys, thank you for watching. Hopefully you give me a like, hopefully you give me a subscribe, share this video, and thank you very much. You have a wonderful evening.